Do you feel it?
My name is Amanda, and I drive a 1994 Toyota Supra. It's twin turbo, 6-speed. The modifications that we've done on it so far, it's just the basic BPU mods, a 4-inch cat-back exhaust, blow-off valve, the larger intercooler, and an intake. I fell in love with the Supra was not only because it's an iconic car and it sounds amazing, but it's what comes with the car. It's the huge Supra community that there is, you know. The people are so nice, they're very welcoming, and I swear the first time you meet them, you become best friends. You find each other on Facebook, you follow each other on Instagram. Getting the Supra was kind of like a secret love affair that I wasn't telling Jared about. We were in the market for a new car for me, and I've always wanted a car that could be modified, that was fast. And so we were looking at a handful of stuff, and I decided on a white hatchback STI. And we specifically wanted the 2014 year, so it was really hard to find. And so as we were car shopping, I kept being more and more in love with the Supra. And so finally one day, I just had to tell Jared that I can't substitute my love for the Supra with the white STI. So I asked him to really look into getting me a Supra. So the reason I wanted my own Supra was just going with Jared for the past year to all of the meets, the cars and coffee, the Supras in Vegas, and just being in love with the scene. So I was just tired of sitting on the sidelines. So one day I said, hey, I want a white Supra, so let's make it happen. Do you feel the vibes? Supra is the stock twin turbo, and I told Jared that I was fine with it, but after sitting in his 800 horsepower car, I think I changed my mind. So I'm waiting for my twins to die so I can trade it in for a single. Some people ask how it feels to drive a 20-year-old car, and at first it hurt to pay that much money for a really old car, but now I don't ever think twice about it. It looks better than new cars nowadays, and I'd rather pay that much money for a car like this than spend it on an average car that you see 15 of every day. So this is my first stick shift car, So I'm learning stick on a Supra. So it kills me every time I kill it. I finally figured out how to go into boost mode, and you have to accelerate to go into boost mode. So this summer, I plan on working side by side with Jared and other Supra owners in the community to learn everything I can about the Supra. How it works, how to fix things, what a squeak means, how I can fix it, so I can be his limb. I look forward to everything that I can learn from the Supra community and being a part of the family that it is.
For the castle.